It's Friday, the 12th of May. This is Business Morning with me, Bosun Omofaye, and we're live to all of you from our global headquarters in Lagos. Welcome to the program. Let's start with one of the biggest economic news in the week ending today. The lifeline for Nigeria's budget 2017, the upper house of legislature finalizes and passes 7.441 trillion naira, about $24.4 billion as 2017 fiscal appropriations or budget. That figure was about 20% higher than the current budget of 2016, running out its course in the month. And some of the key areas of the budget subject to discussions in the days and weeks ahead include the oil benchmark of $44.50 against $42.50 per barrel presented in December last year by President Buhari. The exchange rate, of course, and the various appropriations subheadings. That's already in the news space, and you expect all the economists and analysts to swarm all over the numbers over the weekend and into the new week. The FX markets call the driver of the stock market rally we've seen since the final week of March. Well, everyone thought you should sell in May and go away, but it looks like everyone's sticking around with the market, in particular the foreign portfolio investors. A very nice week so far. So Chukwuma Anyanwu is the head of research at GTI Securities, and it's always good to have him speak to us when things are looking green, so because it brings smiles on everyone's face, especially for folks downtown like Chukwuma, who is sitting down there at GTI Securities trading floor in Lagos. Good morning, Chukwuma.
Good morning, Bosun. It's great to be here.
Yesterday all hell was let loose. The party was across board. Everybody made money.
Yeah, apparently no one is selling in May and going anywhere. It's looking like everybody is coming back into the market in May and staying put.
Actually, this is defined logic. Sell in May, go away. Folks says no, we ain't going nowhere.
Apparently, yeah. But the thing is, I think that's what you get when you're coming out of a recession and you seem to be getting your acts together. When policies are aligning and things are beginning to fall in place, people are going to be staying in May and staying put, you know, for a longer period. Nobody's going anywhere. I can assure you that for now, Bosun.
Yes. However happy we are, some folks are saying perhaps we're almost at the peak, what you call that point in which there's going to be a curve, a bit of an inversion, and perhaps the second half of this month may likely see some profit taking. If that happens, Chukwuma, how much haircut do you think we're going to get when investors decide to pull the trigger and shoot the stock market?
Bosun, it depends on the quality of investors that we are seeing coming back into the market. If we are getting influx of FPI participation back into the market, Bosun, you must take into cognizance the fact that if you look at our market, for instance, let's take Zenith Bank. And I was having this discussion with some of my analyst colleagues yesterday. Let's take Zenith Bank. Zenith Bank is probably trading at about 18. And if you look at that converted to dollars and what the value of that bank was, considering the fact that Zenith Bank in capital base is $1 billion, a billion dollar company, looking at it from the dollar end, they are looking at a company price almost less than one, at least less than a dollar, significantly less than a dollar. It is something that a lot of foreign investors will still want to buy at up to 25 and 30, and it will still make sense. I'm not saying it will get there, but I'm saying that if we are looking at the resurgence of foreign investor participation into the market, then the haircut might not be as significant as people are looking at it, because we've seen the reactions of local investors and local institutional investors or retail, and we've seen that their tolerance level for banks like Zenith is around this point. So if you see anything going above this point for Zenith Bank or some of the other banking stocks, then you are definitely looking at the re-entry of foreign investor participation. And our stocks are relatively cheap compared to where they are coming from. That's what I have to say about that.
Well, I'm likely to think that, yes, the party just got started. So why should it stop so soon? That's my feeling. Since February, when the central bank started this massive attacks, as it were, of the FX market, creating new windows, pumping hundreds of millions of dollars into all these windows almost on a daily, weekly basis. So this is the first time we've seen such in recent years, that the central bank going, shooting on all fours, firing on all fours, as it were. So do you think, yes, we've seen the banking sector and this rapid buying, you talk about Zenith and across all the stocks, we talked about this a few days ago, even the tier two banks, as it were, where you have the likes of WEMA, Sterling Bank, and the rest of them, yes, they are also enjoying this bandwagon effect, as you put it. So, do you think some sectors, like perhaps oil and gas, still have some value in there that could sustain this momentum, as it were?
Actually, where I'm looking at value will be beyond oil and gas for now. I think the sector that has considerably not benefited from the rebound is the construction segment of the market. Julius Berger has more or less remained mute and hasn't done any significant movement but since the market rebound started. So with the passage of the 2017 budget, I think it's a sector that will get a favorable look in. Companies like Julius Berger will probably, depending on how effective their strategy and their drive towards taking advantage of the huge infrastructure gap that the government will be looking at bridging, if they are still as relevant as they used to be in the past with this present government, then we are looking at them getting paid backlogs of monies that they are probably owed in contracts.
Look at what you're saying. Look at what you're saying. Let me cut in there. And I'm surprised how I missed it. Look at yesterday. Dangote Cement was up 4.4%. WAPCO, Lafarge Africa, has been on a losing streak since we started the week. But yesterday, just as that budget was being passed, WAPCO, Lafarge Africa, went up 5%. It was slightly higher by percentage than Dangote Cement. Does that go to confirm your thought that, look, the industrial goods that's been the lackluster since we started Monday smelt this money, $24.4 billion in 2017 budget, and says, this time to kick it in.
Absolutely, Bosin, I agree. And I think that is where we'll probably see some sustainability in the market momentum. I think for banking stocks, we've pretty much seen a lot of very strong movements up to the north. And I think a lot of investors will be a bit wary with going into it. And for the downstream, for the oil and gas, which mostly, apart from Seplat and maybe Oando, are mostly downstream, I think we're also getting some, I expect that we'll see some upward movement as well for stuff like Total. I think the high for Total is about upwards of 300. And I think it will get closer to that point.
Okay, Chukwuma, I think it's good to allow you to have the final trading day. And I'm sure all of you will go have a party this weekend. If anyone is happening around downtown where you folks are celebrating this week's massive rally, put my name at the door. I might just be knocking around there for a few drinks. Thank you. Have a great weekend.